Hello, thank you for your support, and you are welcome to subscribe to our channel. My job is to read this book to my audiences. That is all I am here to do. This channel has full authorization of reading this entire book. Today, I will be reading the book, titled, Unveiling the Secrets of OpenAI and ChatGPT, A Guide to Machine Learning and Beyond. Written by Sean DeLong. Chapter 3, Types of Machine Learning Algorithms. Title 1, Supervised Learning, Unsupervised Learning, and Reinforcement Learning. Now that we've taken a brief look at the evolution of machine learning, it's time to dive deeper into the nuts and bolts of how machine learning algorithms actually work. There are many different types of machine learning algorithms, each with its own strengths and weaknesses, but three of the most common are supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning. In this chapter, we'll explore each of these types of machine learning algorithms in more detail, and look at some of the applications that they are best suited for. We'll also take a critical look at some of the challenges and limitations that each of these algorithms faces, and consider how they might evolve in the years to come. By the end of this chapter, you'll have a solid understanding of the different types of machine learning algorithms, and be better equipped to decide which approach is best suited to your own AI projects. So let's dive in, and take a closer look at supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning. Title 2, Supervised Learning. Supervised learning is one of the most common types of machine learning algorithms, and is used in a wide range of applications, from natural language processing to image recognition to predictive analytics. The basic idea behind supervised learning is to train a machine learning model to make predictions or decisions based on input data that is labeled with the correct output. To give a simple example, let's say you wanted to train a machine learning algorithm to recognize different types of fruit. You might start by feeding the algorithm a large dataset of images of various types of fruit, each labeled with the correct name of the fruit, e.g., apple, banana, orange, etc. The algorithm would then use this labeled data to learn to recognize the features that are associated with each type of fruit, and use this knowledge to make predictions on new, unlabeled data. Supervised learning algorithms can be further divided into two main categories: regression and classification. Regression algorithms are used to predict continuous values, such as the price of a stock or the temperature of a room. Classification algorithms, on the other hand, are used to predict discrete values, such as whether an email is spam or not, or which type of fruit is shown in an image. One of the main benefits of supervised learning is that it can be highly accurate when the training data is carefully labeled and the algorithm is trained with the right set of features. However, there are also some challenges and limitations to this approach. One of the main challenges is that labeled data can be expensive and time-consuming to collect, which can limit the practicality of supervised learning in some applications. Additionally, there is always a risk of overfitting, where the algorithm becomes too specialized to the training data and performs poorly on new, unlabeled data. Despite these challenges, supervised learning remains a powerful tool for a wide range of AI applications, and is likely to continue to be a core technique in the field for years to come. By understanding the basics of supervised learning, you'll be better equipped to make informed decisions about how to apply this technology in your own projects. Title 3, Unsupervised Learning. While supervised learning relies on labeled data to make predictions or decisions, unsupervised learning is a type of machine learning algorithm that is designed to identify patterns or structure in unlabeled data. In other words, the algorithm is not given any specific guidance about what it should be looking for, but rather is tasked with finding interesting or meaningful patterns in the data on its own. One of the main applications of unsupervised learning is in clustering, which involves grouping similar data points together based on some measure of similarity. For example, an unsupervised learning algorithm could be used to group customers into different segments based on their purchase history or demographic data. Another application of unsupervised learning is in dimensionality reduction, which involves reducing the number of features in a dataset while preserving the important information. There are many different types of unsupervised learning algorithms, including k-means clustering, hierarchical clustering, and principal component analysis. These algorithms can be highly effective in uncovering hidden patterns in data, and can be used in a wide range of applications, from recommendation systems to anomaly detection to image and video processing. However, there are also some limitations to unsupervised learning. Because the algorithm is not given any specific guidance, it can sometimes be difficult to interpret the patterns or clusters that it identifies, and it may not always be clear how these patterns or clusters should be used in practical applications. Additionally, unsupervised learning can be computationally expensive and may require large amounts of processing power and memory to work effectively. Despite these challenges, unsupervised learning is a valuable technique for any data scientist or AI practitioner to have in their toolkit. By understanding the basics of unsupervised learning, you'll be better equipped to find interesting patterns and insights in your own data, and to apply these insights to real-world problems. Title 4, Reinforcement Learning. While supervised and unsupervised learning are both concerned with making predictions or decisions based on data, reinforcement learning is a type of machine learning algorithm that is designed to make decisions based on feedback from the environment. The basic idea behind reinforcement learning is to train an algorithm to learn the optimal sequence of actions to take in a given environment in order to achieve a specific goal. To give a simple example, imagine you wanted to train a robot to navigate through a maze. With reinforcement learning, you would start by defining a set of possible actions that the robot could take, e.g. move forward, turn left, turn right, etc., and a set of rewards or penalties that would be given based on the robot's behavior. For example, the robot might receive a reward for finding the exit of the maze, or a penalty for hitting a wall or taking too long to complete the task. The reinforcement learning algorithm would then use these rewards and penalties to update its decision-making process, gradually learning which actions are more likely to lead to a positive outcome. Over time, the algorithm would become better and better at navigating the maze, and could even adapt to new and more complex environments with different goals and challenges. Reinforcement learning has many applications in AI, including robotics, game AI, and recommendation systems. One of the key benefits of this approach is that it can be highly adaptable and flexible, allowing the algorithm to learn in real time from the feedback it receives from the environment. However, there are also some challenges and limitations to reinforcement learning, including the need for a carefully defined set of actions and rewards, and the potential for the algorithm to get stuck in suboptimal solutions. Despite these challenges, reinforcement learning is an exciting and rapidly evolving field, with many new breakthroughs and applications emerging all the time. By understanding the basics of reinforcement learning, you'll be better equipped to explore the potential of this approach in your own AI projects, and to push the boundaries of what we thought was possible with machine learning. Thank you for listening. Chapter 3 of the book, Unveiling the Secrets of OpenAI and ChatGPT, A Guide to Machine Learning and Beyond. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you at the next chapter.